Well, here we go again, right? The gospel of our Lord, there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth, and from those who have little, it will be taken and given to those who have much, right? Where's the good news right there, right? If you don't have anything, guess what? I'm going to take it from you and give it to somebody else who has enough already so that they can have an overabundance, right? This is an interesting lesson we have before us this morning. And on the surface, there's a lot of things that we assume about it. So first we have to get our assumptions out of the way so that we can actually see what this text is telling us. First of all, we assume that it's about money, right? I want to go back a couple weeks because I wasn't here with you that morning because I was attending a funeral of a friend of mine. But there was a couple weeks ago, we had the text where they tried to trick Jesus into telling them not to pay taxes, right? So he asked for a coin, and he said, whose picture is this? Render unto Caesar what is Caesar, and render unto God what is God. Well, there would have been a sermon illustration that morning, which I think fits really, really good to this morning's text as well. In the olden days, there's a story about a group of warriors who, when they got baptized with their right hand out of the water. Right? They go completely into the water, all except for their right hand. And why is that? You hold what warriors hold what in their right hand? Their sword, right? So I think that applies the same today. When we get baptized, we want to get baptized like this. Right? God, you can have all of me, except for this part. Right? Because this morning's text is all about money, right? That's what it's about. Right? The few people that are visiting are, oh God, I'm going to talk about money all morning. No, I'm not really. Because it's not about money. That's one of our assumptions that we have about the sex, that it's all about money, right? Because a talent is the sum of money. And how much is a talent? Anybody have a guess? It's not a day's wage. A day's wage is a denarius. It's not even a year's wage. A talent is between 75 and 90 pounds of silver. 75 to 90 pounds of silver. A denarius is one day's wage. A talent is roughly equal to 20 years of a day's wage. So let's put that into our modern day. The minimum wage currently is $7.25 an hour, so I'm going to round to $7.50 so the math is easier. $7.50 in a day's wage is $60. Thank you. We already went through the math this morning, so she's going to prompt me here. $60 a day. A week would be $300, so 5 times 60 is 300. A year would be $15,600. 20 years is $312,000. So somebody just gives you $312,000 to you, and that's the one talent person, right? This is not some paltry sum if it's about money that this master is handing over to these servants to use. And the other thing that we have to remember about this text when Jesus would have told this, if it's all about money, in Jesus' day there was a limited sum of any resource. So if somebody had 5 talents, and they went out and made 5 more talents, they took 5 talents from someplace. Somebody now has 5 talents less than they did before. There's a limited supply in their minds of every resource. So in order for somebody to gain more wealth, somebody has to be losing wealth. Okay? But is this text really just all about money? And is it about us being good stewards? And you might think, well, of course it is, because it's a stewardship Sunday. They're turning our place for this morning, Pastor. It has to be about this, right? I want to tell you this text is not simply about being a good steward with your money. It is a text about being a good steward overall in all of your life. Because I will tell you first and foremost, stewardship is not about this. Okay? This is one measly little part about what stewardship is about. Stewardship is not about money. We always get worried when we see stewardship because we're worried that it's all going to be about money. But that's not what stewardship is about. Stewardship is being a good steward. And being a good steward is what? Being a good
manager of what has been entrusted to us, right? And that's what our text says. The master who was getting ready to go on a slave called together three of his slaves and he entrusted to them, one 5 talents, one 2 talents, and one 1 talent, according to their ability. He entrusted it to them. We're going to get to it here in a moment where I'm going to tell you that that word is a bad word. Entrusted is not the good word there. Because entrusted gives you the connotation that it's still the master's money, right? The master gave it to them to use and to make money for the master. The master returned and asked for an accounting. That's not what this text is about. This text is about each and every one of us being called to be a beacon of hope for God in this world. And us using our money in one way, and us using our lives in one way, shows that fully. This text is really about what we believe. It's about what we believe. Because what did the third slave believe about the master? He believed that he was right there in the text. That he was a hard man who reaped where he didn't sow and gathered where he didn't scatter, right? He did all the things that were bad, right? And what did the first two slaves believe about the master? It doesn't say, does it? It doesn't say what they believe. Maybe they believe that he was a good and honest man and he did what he needed to do. I can tell you that I can go through this book right here and pull out verses that show you that God is a fair and generous person, or a fair and generous God, and does everything that he does because that he loves us. And I can go through this book and I can pull out verses that will tell you that God is a wrathful God and he's going to do the things against you. Regardless of what you do and how you act, that he's going to damn you to some place that isn't anywhere near where he's going to be, I can find it. It's in here. Both of them. So which one of them is right? Is God a God that's going to completely separate us from him for all eternity, or is he a loving and gracious God? Which one's right? Which one's wrong? In our story this morning, we have two slaves that basically, by their actions, deem that the master is good. And while it doesn't specifically say that the two first slaves thought that the master was good, what tells us that they believe that? What tells us that they believe that the master was good? What did they do with the things that was entrusted to them? They used them for good, to create more. Right? They used what was given to them to create more. Their actions display that they believe that their master was a good man. Right? Their actions display that. So this text is about what we believe. So I can ask you this morning, as I already applied this morning, what do you believe? Do you believe that God is a good and gracious God and is going to give you gifts in order for you to have a life of abundance, to live here in this world, to show forth his grace and his mercy, or is he a God who is going to damn us all and separate us from him for all eternity? What do you believe? You can answer that question for me, but it doesn't matter one hill of beans. You know why? Because if I look at your life Monday through Saturday and I see you doing the exact opposite of what you just told me you believe, then your actions prove to me that you don't believe what you're telling me you believe. The question is not, what do you believe? The question is, what does your life show that you believe? What does your life show that you believe? Because here's the kicker to this whole text this morning, right? The master called together his three slaves, and he entrusted them with the money. The word there is, you're going to learn Greek this morning, is paradidomi. Paradidomi is the word. It's also a word that's found in all of the Gospels in the garden. Jesus is at the Last Supper. He has the Last Supper with the disciples. He goes out to the garden and they're praying. Judas comes in with the guards. And Judas paradidomi Jesus to the Romans. Paradidomi. It's what I say every morning when we come to this table. And the night in which our Savior was handed over. the master handed over to the slave. He didn't say, here's my money, I want you to use it, give it back to me. He said, here's the gift. Use it the way that you believe I would use it. What would you do if somebody handed you $300,000 and said, it's yours to do with as you please? That's the one talent. The five talent slave got $1.5 million handed to them. Not as something they had to return, but as a gift for them to use. Something very precious given to them. And the way that they used it showed forth what they believed. Right? The first two used it in a way that created for their master what they thought their master would have done with the money themselves. And the last one, seeing their master as a wicked person who would take what he didn't, what wasn't belong to him anyhow, went and hid it. He didn't use it at all. And so this text then is about what we believe. And I can ask you again, what do you believe about God? Is God a good and gracious God? Or is he a God that's going to be wicked and reap from where he doesn't sow and gather from where he doesn't scatter? Because your life shows forth what you believe. Because each and every one of us have been given that gift. Have been given multiple gifts. Right? We've all received everything that we've received because of God. And if not, God's not going to come and say, I want all of it back. But someday there is going to be an accounting. The master is going to return and he's going to ask for an accounting from his slaves, his servants. Right? The word doulos in the Bible means slave and servant. We are all servants of God. We've all been given a precious gift from God. And someday God's going to come and ask us for an accounting. What have you done with the gift that I've given you? And see, that's the kicker. Because the first two slaves, when they did what they thought the master would want them to, what did the master say to them? Well done, good and faithful servant. Come in to the joy of your master. They used their gifts to show forth the love of God in their life. They used their gifts to show forth what God has given them. It's about being a good steward of everything that we've been given. It's about being a good steward of these little people that have been entrusted to us to raise them in a way that shows forth that God loves them. It's about using the gifts that we've been given. Using the gifts that we've been given. Right? We use the gifts that we've been given. Sharing them this morning. We're going to have more gifts shared this morning. Talent is not money. Talents are the gifts that we've been given that we are to use in our service to God. And how do we use them? And is God going to welcome us into his joy? Or is he going to ask us why he bothered to give us the great gift that he gave us? I believe that God has given us, each and every one of us, a gift. Each and every one of us. Part of that is our financial understanding of what we have. But that's not all of it. We have to use all of our gifts and talents in service and love of God so that the world will know not by the words that we speak, but by the actions that we do, that we believe in God and trust in the promises that he's given us. And that one day we all will be welcome into that great banquet feast, where people say, welcome home, good and faithful servant. Come into the joy of your master. So use what you've been given. And don't worry about telling people what you believe using the voice. But tell people what you believe by the actions that you take and the way that you live your life. So that without a question of doubt, they know that God is the one who has given you grace. To use the show table.